So hi, I got this thing, and this is like a video while I'm editing the Pentium cleaning the case video. I got this thing for 200 euros, which in my opinion was a good bargain. I got two, and the guy actually wanted to test everything, and I bought it like from 500 kilometers away from me, so from Osijek, and he did turn it on, and the player does turn on, but unfortunately it does not work. Now, his story is that he bought it in the UK when he was in England, and basically that he DJ'd at home for only for a couple of times, and decided that DJing is not for him, and that he wants to sell it. So basically, yeah, this is from UK definitely. Let me turn on the power supply. Okay, my fuse did not blow, which is nice. You know, let me show you the problem. So I never I never did see such issue. So let me insert a CD. Basically, it reads the CD normally, and when I press play, nothing happens. Well, in the CDJ mode it actually works, but in the vinyl mode it does not. So, oh, it's reversed, sorry. Play, and as you can see, this is working fine. But when I press jog, that's the wrong player. No, you see, it stopped. And that's the issue. I have a feeling like the touch is all the time pressed, and it just stops. So I'll be disassembling the player and trying to see what's wrong with the touch. Now, have in mind that this thing looks mint. I mean, this thing does not have a single scratch. So very, very strange issue, because I would expect this thing to be on a CD player that's you know, used and scratched and whatnot. But this thing, it really does look mint. So what I will be doing is disconnecting it and disassembling it and trying to repair it. So yeah, okay, there are like tons of screws, but I actually bought a professional screwdriver. Oh, and by the way, the bloody new screwdriver does not have a USB-C. Why? Okay. And this thing actually looks like it has never been opened. So, yeah. Okay. Can I magnetize this thing? Is it magnetized? Yes, perfect. So far, all of the screws are of the same size, so that's nice. Okay, there is a screw in here as well. This one is smaller, so awesome. Okay, now can I just lift this thing up? Yes, okay. I mean, this thing looks brand new. To be fair, this thing looks awesome. So first of all, this is the display, and I don't actually think that I need to remove the display, but I will see. This wire, let me show you. This wire says touch. Okay, now the reverse button. I will be using this thing to pull the okay, now pull this side. Okay, and then this side. Okay, and then this side again, and I can actually remove the wire, I think. Yes. Same thing in here. This side as well. Okay. This is a broken piece and I didn't break it. Interesting. Okay. And lamp connector in here as well. Oh well. Okay. Strange. This thing was not broken by me, but there you have it. But this thing looks brand new. It really does. This thing looks like nobody used it. And now I need to remove the jog, but basically from here it's actually, I think, easy. Because now I can remove this display as well, together with the touch. Okay. There are only four screws holding the well, everything. Okay, basically all of the screws are of the same size, so somebody used their brains. Awesome. Now I need to remove these four screws. But by the way, this thing looks very nice. And actually it's quite easy to disassemble, I think. Well, so far anyway. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, and 4, and there are only 3. Okay, and now I need to see what's wrong with the touch. I will see. Okay. Now let's put this thing back, right? Oh well, we'll see. That's basically it, right? So I will be placing them in here. And in here, just because that one looks like it's been pressed. So in here. Ah, okay. Okay. So let's screw this thing. And let's install the wheel. So we'll see whether we have figured this thing or not. But I think that this thing might be problem solved. We'll see. So there are four screws that you need to put back. Okay, now the upper main board. I'm gonna install the fifth. It goes in here. Okay, so let's put the display back in. Put this reverse switch inside and let's try to screw this thing in. Okay. No, I will be using this screwdriver, but on the minimum setting so that I don't fuck something up. Okay, and now the display. I'll be so happy if it works, you know. It would be an easy fix. Unfortunately, sometimes the touch just goes bad and there is nothing you can do, but this one was dirty, so you know, that might have been the entire issue. And if that was the case, I would be so happy, you know. Okay. Okay, and now let's push this thing inside. Okay. Okay, money. Now I need to push this thing inside as well. Okay. And now the last part, this one, which is a bit of a hassle, but okay. And it's in. That's what she said. And you know what? I need actually to remove this screw because I need to place this thing in here, even though, to be honest, I don't see a reason why, but it was like that when I opened it. So let me connect the ribbon cable by just pressing it in. See what will happen. Okay, it's in forward mode, it does turn on, but will it play? Okay, it's playing. Just a second. Touch brake. Ha! It's fixed. I don't know, sorry. Let me show you. As you can see, that was the repair. Awesome. Okay, pause. Yeah, it's working. So basically, that was the CDJ repaired. Sorry about the camera angle. So basically, now it's in the CDJ mode and you get to slow down, but when it's in vinyl mode, now as you can see, it's working perfectly. So everything is working. We have a functional CDJ. So until the next video, I guess. Yeah, this was an easy repair. So awesome. Oh, sorry. Now I just need to put this thing back together, but I think that only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws. Yes. Basically, this is done. Awesome. So, yeah. I am quite happy now. Until the next time.